I've never been a nostalgic person. I don't want to play Glenn Miller tunes now. I heard them all. I don't want, and a lot of people like that and they want to bring back the dance band. I'm not like that.
Phil Nimmons is many things. He's a composer, an arranger, a bandleader, clarinetist, and teacher. But at the heart of it all, he's a jazz musician, and jazz is the music of surprise. For Phil Nimmons, the excitement is always for what might be. He might have been a doctor. But long before Nimmons graduated from pre-med studies, music had taken over his life. The young man whose childhood dream was to become a doctor went instead to Juilliard on a clarinet scholarship. He'd go on to become one of Canada's pioneer composers and one of the handful of musicians who'd solidly established the country's status in the world of jazz. Today, at the age of 81, he's still as active as ever, composing, teaching and adjudicating, still agitating on behalf of his passions, and above all, still playing. If you ask him which of all of these activities gives him the most pleasure, he'll answer that it's playing free, making it up as you go. Here he is doing just that with the young Juno Award-winning pianist David Braid for an audience gathered in a church in the town of Dundas, Ontario.
We just show up, and the only rehearsal that we have is, and I say this somewhat facetiously, is that we have either on the phone or something, and we discuss what we're going to wear, because then we just show up and we play. I find it very exciting at my age to be doing this with this young man. I'm inclined to talk a lot. And so I talk to the people, and I want to nourish that communication, that contact with my audience. And if I can do it verbally and bring them all into my living room, so to speak, we're going to have a much better time.
I really hope you're having as much fun as I am. You know, it's great to be doing this and still breathing, you know? David doesn't know quite what to make out of me. He studied with me at 4 years at the University of Toronto Faculty of Music, and he still hasn't figured me out, you know? I've managed to keep the wool over his eyes all these times, you know, in spite of his talent. It's really, man, such a joy, you know? You won't know about this unless you get to be 81 and have a young punk playing the clarinet who's only 29, okay? And I want you to write me a letter in the land of 2 and 4, okay? So should we play one more? Okay. Are you ready? How many of you out there know what we're doing?